Hello, student.
How are you today?
I'm fine, I'm okay. Better than yesterday.
Do you know that? This morning, I drink coffee, no sugar, but taste is so sweet. Because I drink coffee with my girlfriend. Okay, do you remember that today we have two lecturers talking about importer?
Yeah.
Next, the lecturer will explain about it. Pay attention.
Hello, my name is Maxime Kositamani.
Hello, my name is Chili Pong Musetti. Today, we'll explain about the case study of Anuna Company related to international commercial term. First, Lakshmi will explain about the case study.
Thank you. Anuna Company ordered this 10 parent silicone rubber sheet, thickness of 5 mm, one container, from Shenzhen Lai Mai Su Silicone Industry Company Limited, or LMS Company, Guangdong, China, to Anuna Company, Amatak City, Rayong, Thailand. And next, LMS Company sent a silicone container at the origin specific place, Shenzhen Seaport, to Lamsubang Seaport. Container from the Shenzhen Seaport to destination place Anuna Company. By this transportation, we use CIP or carriers and insurance paid too. What is CIP? Who know about CIP?
Yeah, CIP is the one of import term.
Yes, of course. CIP, or carriers and insurance paid too, is the one of import term that the seller will pay for the cost of carriage or the freight and any expense that occur at the place of delivery and take responsibility for all of the rig until the specific place of origin, and after that, buyer will be take all of the rig. However, the seller will buy the insurance for the buyer against all the damage. The seller will be contract and pay the insurance by himself. And next, I will explain obligation of buyer and seller. Obligation of seller. First, prepare the goods, invoice, and any evidence as specific on the contract. Second, the seller must make a contract for transportation of goods. Third, pay for insurance fees, explains for passing export formalities, tax, duty, and other charges to be paid for exports. And fourth, take responsibility until the product delivery at a specific place of origin. And next, Michelle Paul will explain about case study.
For an factory. First, the company will prepare the silicone one container for Anuna Company. Second, make a contact with a transportation company to ship the silicone container from Shenzhen Seaport to Lamsubang Seaport. And finally, the AMS will pay for expense of exporting formality, freight, and insurance. And responsibility of the LMS factory will end at the silicone container out of the factory to Shenzhen Seaport. And the first question. The LMS factory away time for the silicone container one day before the shipment. Should be the responsibility leaks of LMS or not? Who can answer the question?
No, because the responsibility of the seller built-in at a specific place of origin. In this case, Shenzhen Seaport. But the seller will buy the insurance for coverage default to origin.
Explain that correct. For an owner company, responsibility of leaks after the silicone container at the Shenzhen Seaport will be for an owner company such as import formality, excise head, and unloading from the vessel. And the last question, unloading caught from the vessel at Lam Chabang Seaport should be responsible for whom?
An owner company.
That's great. Next, transportation mode. The transportation mode that we use are tug and sea. The tug is used to carry the silicone container from the RMS factory to the vessel at Shenzhen Seaport. The vessel carry the silicone container from the Shenzhen Seaport, China to Lam Chabang Seaport, Thailand, and use the tug to move the silicone container from the destination Lam Chabang Seaport to another company. Why do we shoot tug and sea? For the water, we use the vessel because it can ship at the large weight in the one time at the low cost and suitable for the product that has a lot of weight. And our company ships the silicone in form of container, which are able to be convenient for your food to move with other modes, such as truck and train. Although the time of transportation is low but acceptable for our company. For the land, we use truck because it has door-to-door service that are comfortable to moving or pick up the product. It has faster delivery and does not have a stop point, so the product might not be lost along the way. Cost effective in short distance is suitable with our transport because the RMS factory is away from Shenzhen Seaport 40 km and Lam Chabang Seaport is away from Anona Company 55 km. And the last topic is law related to transportation. The law that we concern in domestic transportation, which are the Land Transportation Act 2522 and Multimodal Transportation Act 2548. By the Act, is related to the tug that we use in Thailand. And the law that we concern in international transportation as following Carriage of Goods by Sea Act 2534. By this Act, we use for the international transportation by sea from Shenzhen Seaport to Lam Chabang Seaport. And this is our case study of Anona Company. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact on anona@gmail.com. And for today, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. For who answered the question, please come to receive a gift voucher and take photo in front of class.